Hello, I welcome all GTCMA members. Now please see, in this session we are going to discuss section 6.1 which is for residential status of an individual. Now before starting this study of RS for an individual, let us first, you know, learn certain important points. Point number one is, why we need to study residential status? What really is the significance of residential status? The answer to this is that RS is something which we can say that it is the very first step for the computation of taxable income of any SSC. This is the very first step. That simply means if you want to compute the taxable income or tax liability of any SSC, first you must know his RS. Okay? So if you want to compute my tax liability for a particular previous year, the very first step is that you must establish what is my residential status for that previous year. This is the very first step. Now, without this, you cannot compute my taxable income. Why? Because the income which are taxable in the hands of a particular SST, it really depends on the residential status of the SST. Okay? For example, if your RS, if your residential status is of resident, certain incomes would be taxable in your hands. But if your residential status is not resident and you are a non-resident, then maybe number of those incomes may not be taxable in your hands. Okay? So first, whenever you know, try to compute taxable income for anybody, for any SST, the very first step is to first work out his RS for the given previous year. Okay? This is the significance of the study of, you know, section 6.1 RS, right? Now you can see on your boards that already I have made the classification for RS for individual. Okay, the idea here for these small short video clippings is that in minimum possible time you must have a clarity onto a particular concept of income tax. This is the whole idea behind these short videos related to the important concepts of income tax. Okay. Now, here I must, you know, quote that undoubtedly these videos are made for the students of CACMACS, maybe the students of LLB, right? Or people who are doing PG diploma in taxation, right? But apart from them, any other person who is a working person, all working persons nowadays, they need to file their ITR. Okay? And if you see the ITR form, you would find the very, you know, the initial steps in filing your ITR is to first you need to give your residential status. Okay? So if you are a working person, this video is also for you. Here, you would now know that how your residential status is worked out for a previous year. Okay? So through this video, you can now know your residential status, how your residential status is ascertained in income tax. Okay, now let me start it. Now please, you can see that a classification for RS of individual is given here, a classification. Okay, since everything is already, you know, noted down here on the board, now I would ask you to focus only on this classification. Only on this classification first, only up to this. Do not read whatever is written here, just focus on this particular classification, right? You can now see that in individual, there are initial two classifications. That means your individual, he may be a resident or he may be a non-resident. Now, how he would become a resident or a non-resident, it is based on certain basic conditions. I would tell you what are those basic conditions, but first let us, you know, have a clarity on the overall classification of RS for individual, right? Please see that this classification, overall classification, it is in two levels. Okay. Here is a perforated line here. Above the perforated line, this is the level 1 of the classification, and under this line is the level 2, the level 2nd of the classification. Now, if you see the level 1 classification, you would see that your individual, he may be classified into either resident or a non-resident. Okay. Once you establish that your individual is a non-resident, your work is over, your task is over. A non-resident is a final RS for the individual. Okay. So, you have established that your SST, your individual SST is a non-resident. That means you have finally established his RS. No need for any other, working for working out his RS. This RS, non-resident, it is a final RS for the individual. But in case, by applying the basic conditions, you come to know that your individual SST, he is a resident, then your task is still not over. You need to further check. You need to go down to the second level. And you would further check whether this resident, he is an ordinary resident or a not ordinarily resident. So, the second level classification here, you can see that this classification, it comes from resident only. This classification comes from resident. Okay. Once you establish that your individual SST is a resident, you need to further clarify whether this resident is ROR, that means resident and ordinary resident, or he is RBNOR, that means he is a resident but not ordinary resident. Okay, now how we would check it? What is the test for it? The test here would be certain additional conditions. I will tell you about additional conditions at the right time. So now we have a clear-cut idea of the classification of RS. Okay. First, your individual SST, he could be a resident or a non-resident. Okay. If he comes to be a non-resident, your task is over. He has now become a non-resident. Right. But in case you observe that he has now become a resident, then you need to go further. You need to classify him further into ROR or RBNOR. Okay. This is the overall classification. So, the three final residential status for an individual SST is, number one, either he could be resident and ordinary resident, ROR. Number two, he could be RBNOR. That means resident but not ordinary resident. And at number three, it is non-resident. So, for an individual, there are three RS. Number one, ROR. Number two, RBNOR. Number three, non-resident. Okay. If for an individual, you would only say that he is a resident, your sentence is absurd, because resident is not a full and final status for individual. Either the individual, he could be ROR or he could be RBNOR. Okay. Now, we know the classification. Now, let's come into that this part, that how you are going to establish that your individual SST, he is a resident or a non-resident. Now, to establish this, we have been given two basic conditions. Now, you must focus here. Basic conditions, these two points. We got only two basic conditions. On the basis of these basic conditions, we would then establish whether your individual is a resident or a non-resident. Okay. Now, please see there are two basic conditions. The basic condition number one is that your SST, individual SST, he is in India for a period of 182 days or more during the relevant previous year. Okay, simple condition, your SST, he is in India for 182 days or more during relevant previous year. Basic condition number two, please note that basic condition number two, it has two different parts. The first part of basic condition number two is that your individual SST, he is in India for a period of 60 days or more. The second part here is that in last four previous years, he is in India for a period of 365 days or more. Now, please note when I say last previous year, that means the previous year earlier to your relevant previous year. Please see in basic condition number 1, when we check that he should be there in India for a period of 182 days or more, we are checking his availability in India during the relevant previous year. Okay, so in basic condition number 1, 182 days you are checking his, you know, stay here in the relevant previous year. Okay, come to basic condition number 2, when you check the 60 days in relevant previous year, that means you are checking his stay of at least 60 days in the relevant previous year. But the second part of the second basic condition, it says 365 days in 4 last previous years. When we say 4 last previous years, that means the previous years, the 4 previous years earlier to the relevant previous year. So, if your relevant previous year is say 2018-19, the 4 previous years we need to look for would be 2017-18. Okay? We are not taking 2018-19. Your 18-19 is your relevant previous year. So, we are taking the 4 previous years immediately preceding the relevant previous year. That means you would take 2017-18, 16-17, 15-16 and 14-15. These would be the 4, you know, previous years which you need to see for checking his stay, whether it is for 365 days or not. Okay? So, you got the meaning here? Then you need to check his stay during the relevant previous year, and then you need to see his stay earlier to the relevant previous year. Okay? Now please see, these are the two basic conditions here. Okay? Now focus here. I am now telling you that when you apply the basic conditions, how your SSC would become resident and how he would become a non-resident. Okay? The simple rule here is that if your SSC, he fulfills at least one of the basic conditions, at least one, that means at least one or maybe both. If he fulfills at least one of the basic conditions, then he would become a resident. Okay? Only in a case where he does not fulfill any of the basic conditions, where he is not fulfilling any basic condition, then only he would become a non-resident. Okay? Even if he fulfills one single basic condition, he would be taken as a resident here. Now please focus here, please see that I have written here anyone or both of BC. So your individual, if he satisfies anyone or both of basic conditions, he would become a resident. Okay? See the other side, it is written here none of basic conditions. That means if your SSC, he does not satisfy any of the basic conditions, then he would be taken as a non-resident. So far very simple. Okay. Now please see, this is one important point here. Let me tell you that in case of an individual SSC, right, you need to check both of the basic conditions. Right. But in three different situations, which we call the exceptions here, right, the individual, he must fulfill basic condition number 1 to be a resident. I am again repeating it. Generally, in case of an individual, you need to apply both of the basic conditions. The individual would be checked on both of the basic conditions. Okay? But, in case your individual, he falls in any of these three categories, then for such kind of individual, okay, condition number 1, it becomes mandatory for him. It is the only condition and is the mandatory condition for him. Okay, that means any individual which falls in any of these three conditions, right, he must fulfill first condition to become a resident in that previous year. Okay. What are these three exceptional situations? Number 1, if your individual is leaving India for the purpose of employment. Here is an individual who is now leaving India, who is going abroad for the purpose of employment. If such a case, in case of this kind of individual, okay, the first basic condition is mandatory to be fulfilled to become resident. Such a person, if he is not fulfilling the first condition, okay, he would not become a resident, he would be taken as a non-resident. Please note that in three exception categories, there remains only one basic condition for these three categories, condition number 2, it becomes useless. It is now not for these three kind of exceptions. Okay, for these three kind of exceptions, there is only one basic condition. Right, for all other individuals who do not fall in any of these situations, any of these exceptions, for them there are two basic conditions. For the individuals who fall in any of these three exceptional situations, they got just one single, the first basic condition. Okay, so if such kind of individuals, they fulfill the first basic condition, that means their stay in the relevant previous year in India is 182 days or more, they would become resident, otherwise they would be taken as non-resident. Okay, so the first exception here is that the individual, he is leaving India for the purpose of employment. The second one is, again, the individual is leaving India as a member of crew of a ship. You all know that if it is a ship, it certainly will go outside India to any other, you know, country. So if you are an employee there, you are the crew member there in that ship, we cover this situation as in our exceptions. Okay, the third point here is, please understand this, the third point here is that an individual who has his Indian origin, he is of Indian origin, right, his roots are here in India, okay, and such an individual, he has settled abroad, okay, his family's house is there, you know, in some other country abroad. Right? And such a person, such an individual has come into India during the relevant previous year. So these are the three exceptional situations. I am again repeating, in case of individual, you need to refer both of the basic conditions. But if your individual, he falls in any of these three exceptional categories, exceptional situation, in that case there is only one basic condition for them. Okay, no second condition for the cases who falls under exception. Okay, so there are three exceptions. One, the individual is leaving India for the purpose of employment. Second, the individual is leaving India as member of crew of an Indian ship. And third, the individual who got his Indian roots, Indian origin, and who is settled outside India, he has come to India during the previous year. What is the meaning of Indian origin? Indian origin means that the SSP himself, the individual himself, or his parents, any of his parents, or any of his grandparents, if they are born in India, then we would say that the SSP has got Indian roots or he is of Indian origin. Now please see, we have taken this up to, you know, grandparents. So there could be a case where any of the grandparents, they may be born in India in say 1940. And you all know that in 1940, all the part related to Pakistan as well as Bangladesh, that was nothing but India only. Right? So somebody, he born in India in 1940. When I say India, let us suppose that he born in Lahore. Lahore is now in Pakistan. Right? But in 1940, Lahore was definitely, it was certainly part of India. Or a person, one of the grandparents, he is born in Dhaka. Dhaka is now, no, Bangladesh, right? But in 1940, Dhaka, it was also India, right? So, in case any person, the SSP or any of the parents or any of his grandparents, if they are born before 1947, you need to take the undivided India into your reference. Then you would, you know, the definition for India would be the undivided India. You are getting me? Okay, so now you know how to work out whether your SSP, individual SSP, he is a resident or a non-resident. Okay, let me now sum up the case of classifying an individual into resident or a non-resident. Right, an individual, he could be a resident or non-resident based on how far he fulfills the basic condition. There are two basic conditions. Number one, he is in India for 182 days or more. Second, he is in India for 60 days in relevant previous year and for 365 days or more during last 4 previous years. Okay. So, if the individual, he satisfies any of the basic conditions, he would become resident. Otherwise, he would become a non-resident. Now, there are three exceptions here. If the individual falls under any of these three exceptions, then For the exceptional cases, there is just one basic condition, the first basic condition, and the second basic condition does not apply in these three exceptional situations. Okay, so that simply means the conclusion here for the exceptional individual is that if they are here in India for a period of 182 days or more during the relevant previous year, then they would become resident, otherwise they would be taken as non-resident. Okay, so now we know the first classification of the RSF individual. Now coming to the second, you know, level of classification. If you are SST, on the basis of the basic condition, if he has become a resident, you need to further check whether he is ROR or he is RBNOR. Okay. Now, to check this, we got two additional conditions. We have two additional conditions to check whether your resident, he is an ordinary resident or a not ordinarily resident. Okay. These two additional conditions are, number one, that he is in India for 730 days or more during last 7 previous years. Now again, when I say last 7 years, that means the 7 years time period earlier to or which immediately precedes your relevant previous year. So if your relevant previous year is 2018-19, then the 7 years you need to take from 17-18 and the earlier 6-1. Okay, do not take the relevant previous year under these 7 years. No. The 7 years time period you must see which immediately precede the relevant previous year. Okay, this is your first additional condition, that the SST, he is in India for a period of 730 days or more during last 7 previous years. Okay, the second additional condition is that your SST individual, he must be a resident for at least 2 previous years out of 10 previous years immediately preceding the relevant previous year. That means prior to your relevant previous year, you need to check a period of 10 years, and out of these 10 years, your individual SST, he must be a resident for at least 2 years. Now, how you would check that he is a resident? The answer is very simple. If he fulfills any one of the basic conditions, he would become a resident. So, out of 10 years, he needs to be resident here for at least 2 years. That means 2 years or more. This is the second additional condition. Now, please see here that if your SST, he fulfills both of the additional conditions. If your SST, he fulfills both of the additional conditions, then he would become ROR. Okay, otherwise he would be taken as RBNOR. Now you can see here, please see, in case of resident, the classification is ROR and RBNOR. Here it is written, if both of the additional conditions are satisfied, then he would become ROR. Otherwise, anyone, if he satisfies any one or none of the additional conditions, then he would be taken as RBNOR. Is it clear? So, the second level of classification again is now clear to us, right? So, now I would summarize. If you have understood the first and the second level, both of these levels, right, then can you tell me when an individual would be taken as ROR? The answer here should be that when your individual, he would satisfy at least one of the basic conditions plus he would satisfy both of the additional conditions, then he would become ROR. When he would become RBNOR, he would become RBNOR when at least he satisfies one basic condition, plus he is not satisfying both of the additional conditions. That means either he is satisfying only one additional condition or he is not satisfying any of the additional conditions. Then your individual SST, he would be taken as R, B and O, R. And how your individual would become a non-resident? The answer is very simple. If your individual SST, he is not satisfying any of the basic conditions, then he is not satisfying any of the basic conditions, he would become a non-resident. Okay? My dear ones, this was section 6.1, residential status of an individual. Okay? I hope this is now very much clear to you. I thank you all for this session.